Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss prototypal inheritance. An object has a prototype, which is known as the internal linkage to a higher hierarchy of objects. And in this video, I'm going to tell you the way to assign the prototype properly. And I'm also going to discuss the hasOwnProperty method to help us check for the objects that possess a property. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. I just have a title and a heading. And this HTML file links to a certain JavaScript file called myscript.js, which is put in the JS folder. And in order for me to use the strict mode, I have to say use strict at the beginning of the JavaScript file. And now I'm going to discuss the prototype issue. Every object has a prototype property, which is known to serve as an internal linkage to another object of higher hierarchy. The word hierarchy here means that we want to build other objects based on some properties, and then we have new kinds of objects that are similar to some higher hierarchies. And I'm going to discuss this word in more detail later on with an example. If the prototype is not set by the user, then it is set as null automatically. But if we want to have some kind of inheritance relationship, then we have to set the prototype properly so that we can do the setup of our own objects. And if a property doesn't exist in an object, the JavaScript language will try to find it from the prototype hierarchy. That is the power of inheritance that I will discuss later on with an example. Now, let us see an example like this one. Suppose now I have a vehicle object that has a key value pair, which tells us the color of the vehicle. And I have a function called move so that the vehicle can move. And I have another object called fan. And a fan can adjust the platform so that the car can be raised or lowered. So is there any kind of relationship between the fan and a vehicle? If we think about it more deeply, there is some kind of relationship between the two objects. Actually, a fan is a type of a vehicle, or we can say that a fan is a specific type of a vehicle. So a vehicle can represent a bus, a truck, a taxi, a fan, and so on. And a fan is just one of the possible types of a vehicle. So if we want to emphasize this kind of relationship, we can say that a fan actually has a prototype, which is called a vehicle. So a vehicle can help us specialize a certain fan. So if you want to specify this kind of relationship between a vehicle and a van, I can do something like this. Now I'm going to set up the prototype of the fan which goes to the vehicle object. For this pattern, some people would say it as a thunder proto, which means something like this one. Double underlined proto. So this pattern is called thunder proto by some people. Okay. So if I set up the prototype of the fan to be a vehicle, it means that the properties coming from a vehicle will also appear in the fan. So a fan here is also white in color, and a fan can also move in addition to adjusting the platform itself. Other than using the thunder proto approach shown here, which is an indication inside the fan object, I can also set up the prototype relationship outside the object. Let me show you the way. In this approach, I'm able to set the prototype relationship outside the object definition. So you can use this one or that one to do the prototype assignment. So let me show you the relationship between the fan and the vehicle now. Of course, you can expect that the fan can have an adjustment of the platform because the method is stated inside the fan object. So let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you can see that adjusting platform is coming out because I just used the method from the fan object. But how about after the linking shown here? If I do the prototype assignment, it is sensible for us to expect that the fan is also able to do what a vehicle does. So a fan also has the color in white, and a fan is also able to use the method provided by the vehicle object, which is the prototype of a fan. So let me see. Now let me save it and reload the page. Yes, the fan is white because it just inherits the color from the prototype, which is called vehicle. And of course, the fan can also move because the fan also inherits the method coming from the prototype called vehicle. So this is the power of prototypal inheritance. When you have this kind of linkage, or this kind of linkage, you're able to connect a certain object with another one in order to set up a prototypal relationship. Now I'm going to do the inheritance further. An ambulance is usually a fan, and of course an ambulance is a pretty special type of vehicle. And if I want to specify this kind of relationship so that an ambulance can have its own method called alarm in addition to the inherited methods called address platform and move method, I'm able to do the assignment of the prototype of the ambulance to an appropriate object. How can I do so? Let me show you now. Now I just assigned the prototype of an ambulance to a van. And of course, a van also inherits the properties from the vehicle. So if I say the prototype of an ambulance is a van, the ambulance is already able to link to the vehicle prototype because we have set up a hierarchy from ambulance to van and to vehicle from bottom to top. In addition to setting up the prototype, how about changing the key value pairs inherited? It is possible to do so in JavaScript. Let me show you the way. Okay, I say color colon yellow. So I'm able to do the overwriting of the properties of the prototype. Originally, fan is white in color because the fan has inherited the color from the vehicle. So if you want to change the color of an ambulance, you can do the assignment in your ambulance object. So the fan is still white because of the inheritance, and a vehicle is also white by default, but your ambulance object is yellow in color. So I can show you the situation right now. I'm trying to use the alarm from the ambulance because this alarm function is of course a function inside the ambulance object, so it is sensible to use it directly. Save. Reload. Yes, I can switch on the alarm because this method comes from the ambulance object directly. Is the ambulance able to address the platform like a fan does? Yes, it is possible. Let me show you now. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that the ambulance is able to call the address platform function inherited from the fan object. So that is the power of the prototypal inheritance by using the thunder proto statement shown here. And of course, an ambulance is able to move because an ambulance is also a type of vehicle. So let me show you now. Save. Reload. Yes, the ambulance is able to move because it just inherits the method coming from the van, which inherits the method coming from the vehicle. So we have set up a hierarchy in this way. And how about the color of the ambulance? Let me show you now. Let me save it and reload the page. Yes, it is yellow because I have set up the color explicitly in the ambulance object by overwriting the original inherited key value pair. And we have to notice something like here. Vehicle seems to be in the highest hierarchy of our objects. In JavaScript, it is not the case. Vehicle is not the highest hierarchy. And the vehicle has also its own prototype called Object.prototype, which is the highest prototype allowed in JavaScript. So originally, vehicle is already the highest in our objects, but it is not the case. The Object.prototype is still the highest prototype allowed in the JavaScript language. How can I know this fact? I can have a look at the developer tools. Click on here, more tools, web developer tools. Let me go to the console, and then I say console.log bracket vehicle semicolon. When I press enter, you can see that the prototype of a vehicle is the object.prototype shown here. The object.prototype has helped us inherit a lot of built-in properties shown here. So you can see that it seems like the vehicle is already in the highest hierarchy, but it also has its own prototype called object.prototype shown here. So let me close it and go to other topics to discuss. And actually, we can loop over the own properties of a certain object and its inherited properties. So we can distinguish between the own properties and the inherited properties. How can we do so? We can use a for loop to do it. Let me show you the way. Now, I just set up a for in loop to loop over the key in our ambulance object. And if the ambulance object has some own property identified by the key, I would say that that is its own property. If the ambulance has some properties inherited from the higher hierarchies, the alert window will say that that key is an inherited property. So I have to mention something here. The hasOwnProperty method is a built-in method from the object.prototype. How can I know this one? I can just go to the developer tools again. Let me save it first. Save. And let me go to the developer tools. More tools. Web developer tools. Yes, I can go back to the console and let me type something. I want to see the ambulance content. And I can see something like this one. When I go to the prototype, I can have the hierarchy showing up here. Yes, that is the highest hierarchy called object.prototype. And you can see that we have a method called hasOwnProperty. So that's why I say that the hasOwnProperty method is a built-in method of object.prototype, because I just inherit the object.prototype method down to my ambulance object. Okay? So let me run the program. Reload the page. Alarm is the own property. Let me check. Of course, it is correct because the alarm method is built inside the ambulance object. And color is also its own property because the color is already overwriting the original color inherited from the fan. Okay? And address platform method is the inherited property. Why? Because it inherits from the fan object. And the move method is also an inherited property because we can see that the vehicle object has the move function. So by using the hasOwnProperty function, we are able to check whether a key belongs to the object itself or belongs to the inherited hierarchy. So this video has already discussed the prototypal inheritance. The idea is to use the thunder proto keyword. We can do the assignment of the prototype inside the object or outside the object, like this one. And we can change the key value pairs by overwriting the key value pairs inherited. And of course, we are able to check whether a certain key is inherited from the higher hierarchies or it is a built-in one from the object itself. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.